Hello everyone. We are going to discuss the continuity equation in fluid motion. The motion of ideal fluid is governed by two principles. One, the continuity equation. Two, the Bernoulli's equation. So I'm writing the motion of ideal fluid is governed by two principles. One, the continuity equation. Two, the Bernoulli's equation. The continuity equation is an expression, okay, for conservation of mass for incompressible fluid flow. Okay, that is no fluid is created or destroyed. So we must note this, okay? Therefore, the total mass, okay, mass of the fluid must remain constant. So this is for the equation of continuity. And in case of Bernoulli's equation, okay, conservation of energy is applied to the fluid flow. So we have this equation of continuity is based on conservation of mass, whereas Bernoulli's equation is based on conservation of energy for the fluid flow. Let us understand equation of continuity in more detail with mathematical equation, okay? So let us consider a tube with non-uniform cross-sectional area, okay? So let us consider two sections of the tube. So this is section one and another we have section two, okay? This is section two of the same tube, and we can see clearly area of cross section at section one and area of cross section at section two is not same. So I'm writing over here figure tube or pipe with non-uniform cross-sectional area. So we have this. So
thank you.
Let us consider an ideal fluid moving horizontally through the tube, okay, as shown in figure, okay, having non-uniform cross-sectional area. So we have this, okay, and let the fluid, okay, let the fluid have steady motion, okay, or let the fluid move in steady way. Let the fluid have steady motion. The motion of the fluid is steady, okay. So we have this. Now, for ideal fluid, okay, the density of the fluid remains constant. So for ideal fluid, okay, rho is constant. So this is what density, okay, that is ideal fluid is incompressible. So we need to note this, okay. So we have this. So we have a ideal fluid moving horizontally through a tube or pipe having different cross-sectional area, and the fluid flow is steady, okay. So we have this. Now let us consider section 1 and 2 separately, okay. Section 1 and section 2 separately. So let V1 be the fluid speed at section 1, and A1, this is CSA of section 1, and let x1, okay, be the distance traveled by fluid in time delta t. So we have this, and we know this, okay. So let me write over here. We know speed equals distance by time. So therefore we can write x1, which is distance traveled by fluid at section 1 in time interval delta t. So x1 equals v1, okay, fluid speed at section 1 times delta t. So we have this, clear? Now in same way we can write at section 2, v2 is fluid speed at section 2, a2, this is cross-sectional area of section 2, okay, and x2 is distance, okay, this is distance traveled by fluid, okay, at section 2 in time delta t, okay. So we can write in same way, okay, we can write x2 equals v2 times delta t. Now let us find the mass of fluid, okay, which is moving into the tube, okay, through area A1. So we have this, okay. So this is section one of the tube, okay. This is section one, with CSA, A1. We want to find the mass. We want to find mass moving into the tube, okay, into the tube through area A1 in time delta t. So I'm writing over here, this is mass, okay, moving or mass flowing, let me write in this way, mass flowing into the tube through A1 at time delta t. And we know density equals mass by volume. So we can write mass equals density and volume is area times the distance. Okay. So we can simply write delta M1 equals density, that is rho, because we know density of ideal fluid, which is incompressible, remains constant. Okay. So rho A1 X1. So we can write delta M1 equals rho A1, and X1 is V1 delta T. Okay. So I'm using this equation or rewriting equation. Okay. So we get this. So this is the mass moving into the tube. So this is mass entering. Okay. This is mass entering into the tube through cross-sectional area A1 in time delta T. So we have this. Now, in same way, we can write, okay, delta M2. So let me first draw this, okay. So X2 is the distance, okay. This is distance traveled by the fluid, okay, at section 2 in time delta T. Okay, so we have this. Now, delta M2, this is mass flowing out, okay, that is mass moving out through section 2 or through cross-sectional area A2, okay, at time delta T. So in same way, we can write delta M2 equals rho A2, okay, we write in same way, okay, rho is constant and we have A2 for section 2, okay? And the speed is V2 at section 2, and time is delta T. So we have this. So this is mass leaving, okay? This is mass leaving out. This is mass leaving out. So we have this. Okay. Now, for steady flow, okay, total mass in the tube is constant. So we have this, okay? So therefore we can write delta M1 equals delta M2. So we have this, okay? So we have delta M1, density rho, cross-sectional area A1, speed of the fluid V1, and time is delta T, okay? So this equals, we have delta M2, so we have rho A2, V2, delta T. So density cancels from both sides, time delta T cancels from both sides. So we are left with this, okay? A1 V1 equals A2 V2. That is product of cross-sectional area of the tube and fluid speed is constant. So we can generalize this equation and write in this way, okay? Product of area of the tube, that is cross-sectional area of the tube with the speed of the fluid is constant. So we can write in this way, clear? And from this equation, okay, we have V1 by V2 equals A2 by A1. So we can write in this way, okay? Speed, that is fluid speed, is inversely proportional to cross-sectional area of the tube. Okay? So what we find, if area of cross-section increases, okay, then the fluid speed decreases. So we find this, okay, cross-section area and fluid speed, they are inversely proportional to each other. And if area of cross-section decreases, then fluid speed, increases. Okay, so we find this. So I'm writing over here, A1 B1 equals A2 V2. Or we can generalize this equation and rewrite in this way. Area times speed is constant, okay? So this is called equation of continuity, okay, for incompressible fluid. This is the equation of continuity, or we can generalize and write area times speed of the fluid is constant. So this is called the equation of continuity. So we need to note this. Now, okay, now let us find the mass flow rate. Okay, so if we generalize these two equations, then we can write in this way, okay, delta m equals density rho cross sectional area of the tube A, speed of the fluid V, and we have time delta t, okay? So I'm generalizing these two equations. So we get this. So delta m by delta t, this is called mass flow rate. So this equals density rho cross-sectional area of the tube A and V, the speed of the fluid. So this is also called, or we can also write equation of continuity. Okay, in this form, okay. Now let us find volume flow rate, or it is also called volume flux. Okay, so we want this volume, that is delta V by delta T. So this is volume, okay? This is volume. So we want to find this, okay? Now, we know, let me do some rough work. Density equals mass per unit volume, okay? So we have volume equals area times thickness, okay? So we can write in this way. So delta x is the distance, okay? This is the distance. This is distance, okay? This is distance. So if we consider our previous figure, okay? This is section one. We have x, so I'm generalizing, okay? Or let me write in this way. X1 is the distance traveled by fluid in time delta t. So we can generalize this and write simply x as the distance traveled by the fluid. Clear? So we are having this. So we can write delta V by delta T as cross-sectional area A, delta X by delta T. So this gives distance traveled by fluid. So this ratio, okay, this ratio is distance traveled by fluid in time interval delta T. So we can write in this way, A times V, because this is the fluid speed. So we can write volume flow rate dv by dt equals cross-sectional area of the tube times the speed of the fluid. And we know this product is constant, okay? So this is constant. So we can write in this way. This is constant. So this is the another way of writing equation of continuity. So this is also called, okay, this equation. So we can write equation of continuity in this way. Delta V by delta T equals cross-sectional area of the tube times the speed, and this product is constant. So this is the another form of writing equation of continuity.